Crystal.
Hello.
Welcome to Concrete and Cranes.
Let's see who visited us here last week on our first day of VBS. Give a big brother's welcome to Caleb, Samaria, and Adriana.
Woo-hoo!
We're so glad you've joined us today. As you can probably tell by what we're wearing, Connor and I are construction workers. I even brought my toolbox to help with the building.
Crystal and I are pumped to be with you here at VBS.
Last week we heard about how Jesus laid the foundation of love with the story of Matthew and enjoyed some tasty gold coins.
Today we're going to dig up some great information about missions and use our creativity at our craft station.
At Concrete and Cranes, you get to do everything!
So what will you do first?
You're about to find out.
And best of all, by the end of the workday, you'll understand that Jesus' love is the foundation that everything good is built upon.
That's what the Bible says.
The Bible teaches us that Jesus' love provides a foundation that will last, a foundation of love, of forgiveness, of worth, of promise, a foundation for life.
Everything we do today and everything we do here at VBS will help us build our lives on God. John 15:9 says, "As the Father has loved me, I have also loved you. Remain in my love."
We're pumped you're starting your day with us. You're at the right place. Concrete and Cranes, building on the love of Jesus.
Hola, welcome to Missions. We will be digging into the story of a family who is building foundations of friendship so that they can share Jesus' love with the people around them. In today's video, we are going to meet two missionary kids in the Wardy family. Pay close attention as they tell us where they serve and how they are building relationship with the people where they live. Look at these words on the rocks: Arezzo, Boot, Friendship, Outreach Events, and Leaning Tower of Pisa. Listen carefully to these words in the video.
And I'm Ben.
We're missionary kids that live in Arezzo, Italy. Italy is an easy country to recognize because it's shaped like a high heel boot. This is my family, my mom and my dad, and my two big sisters, Emma and Micah, which are away at boarding school right now. And we love to tell people about Jesus. In fact, my big sister Micah got to go on a mission trip to Israel. And just recently, Emma got back from a mission trip to Uganda in Africa, where she got to tell Africans about Jesus. Both trips sound like they were pretty amazing. I just love to see how my sisters love to serve God. Marco Polo! What do Marco Polo, Leonardo da Vinci, and Christopher Columbus all have in common?
I don't know, they're all famous?
No, they're Italian, of course. Italy is home to a lot of famous people and places in history. One of the most famous is this thing,
a Torre di Pisa.
The Leaning Tower of Pisa is actually a bell tower. It looks like it's about to fall over, doesn't it? The tower leans due to the fact on being built on a swamp. Non una buona fondazione. Jesus' love provides a strong foundation for our lives that will last. When life gets hard and you feel like you're starting to lean, remember that Jesus loves you.
Here in Italy, before we tell people about Jesus, we like to build a good relationship with them first. Once we have a firm friendship, then they are open to hear more about Jesus. So we find lots of ways to make friends, by hosting parties, putting on kids' camps, coordinating volunteer groups, doing outreach events, fun activities, and oftentimes inviting Italian families over to our house to make a big meal. We love people and making new friends. It's so much fun. It reminds me of all the stories in the Bible of Jesus hanging out with people he loved and sharing a meal in hopes that they would believe in him.
That's a powerful love, and that's the same reason we are here, to tell people that Jesus loves them and they can count on that love to be a firm foundation in their lives.
Join us as we build on the love of Jesus here in Italy!
The Wardy family is sharing the love of Jesus with people who live there. As you can see, Italy has the shape of a high heel boot. Cool! Missionaries have to build friendship before they can tell people about Jesus. They make friends by hosting parties, volunteer groups, outreach events, inviting people to dinner, you name it. What famous structure was pictured in the video? Yes, the Leaning Tower of Pisa. The tower leans because it was not built on a strong foundation. Jesus is our strong foundation. And building our life on His love, we can be sure that He will carry on the good work He started in us.
Hi, Extreme Kids! Welcome to Bulldozer Crafts. Today we are talking about somebody that loves you so very much, and no, I'm not talking about your mom, or even your dad, or even all of us here at Extreme Kids. I'm talking about someone that loves you even more than all of us combined. Can you guess who it is? Awesome! Yes, you're right! It's Jesus! Jesus loves you so very much, and to help you remember how much He loves you, we're going to make a craft about it. Now, I have all of my materials ready, so I hope that you guys have yours too. But in case you don't, let me remind you. We're going to need a nice marker. We're also going to need some scissors. But be careful. Make sure to ask your parents for help when cutting. We're also going to need some colorful chalk. Now, you can use many colors, but if you don't have many colors, it's okay. You can just use one color. And we also need some hairspray. This is gonna help us in the very end of our craft. And finally, these are some bonus materials. You can also use some tape and some string. Now that we have all of our materials ready, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we're gonna do is grab our piece of paper. And in the paper, we are going to write our name in the very, very center. So my name is Melanie, and I'm gonna put my name in the very center. There. Now, in the top part of our paper, we are going to write Jesus loves. So together we write Jesus loves. Awesome. Now, we're going to grab our second piece of paper and we are going to fold it in half. But we're going to do this hamburger style. So we're going to fold it just like this. Now that we have our paper folded, we are going to draw half of a heart. So we're going to grab it and go like and draw half of a heart. Now that we have half of our heart, we are going to cut it with some scissors. Now, this is the point where you should ask a parent to help you with cutting. All done! We have our heart. Perfect. Now that we have our heart, what we're going to do is put our heart over our name. Now that it's over our name, we're going to grab the chalk that we have and we're going to make an outline. So we're going to draw outward like this. You guys can alternate colors however you want. This is all yours, so you get to choose what colors you use and where and how much of what color. I really like pink. It's my favorite color, so you're probably gonna use a lot of it. What's your favorite color? Write down in the comments so we can all know your favorite color. I'm really curious to know what your favorite color is. Thank you. do long lines to make sure you can tell that it's a heart. Mine's gonna be super duper colorful. Are you guys ready for the reveal? Let's take out our hearts. Wow! That is so cool! Be careful, because there's gonna be some dust. Wanna wipe that out. Look how cool that is! But since it is shock, it will come off really easily. So what we do to make sure that it stays for a long time, we're gonna grab our hairspray. Now, you want to do this really gently and really lightly because you don't want to soak up your perfect piece of artwork. So, what we're going to do, we're going to hold it like this. Let's do it this way. We're going to hold it like this and really far away. We're going to spray it with some hairspray. Make sure that it stays. Ooh. You guys have scented hairspray? Because if you do, it's gonna smell a lot. Anyways, there we go. We have our craft. But if you guys want to take it a whole level up, and if you have some tape and some string at home, then you can make it into a sign. So the way that you make it into a sign is you grab some tape and you cut up some pieces. So here I'm gonna cut up a piece of my favorite glittery tape. And now I have two pieces of my favorite glittery tape cut up. Now that I have those pieces, I'm going to take my artwork and turn it around, right? So it's gonna be this way. We're gonna grab our piece of string. We're gonna put the string on one corner in the very top and put a piece of tape on top of it. Make sure that the tape is sticking really well onto our artwork. Then we're gonna fold it over like this. We're gonna put a piece of tape over the string again and the other side of the paper. And ta-da! We have a sign! And you can put this in your room, or maybe even in your fridge, or maybe even somewhere in your walls at home. But this is a nice reminder that Jesus loves you so very much, and so do we over here at CCR Kids. So, until next time, bye, Extreme Kids!
Will we need to make more side visits tomorrow?
Certainly. We've just begun building on the love of Jesus.
What did you learn today?
I learned that Jesus chooses to love me. I can't earn it.
Jesus chooses to love me.
And he chooses to love you.
There's nothing we can do to earn Jesus' love.
See you next time!